In this tutorial, you'll learn about Scene Converter. Scene Converter is a new feature of 3ds Max 2017 and makes converting an older scene into 3ds Max 2017 specs easier. This is particularly useful when dealing with older scenes with standard materials, cameras, and lights that are not physically accurate by today's standards. Instead of converting these one at a time, Scene Converter does the job for you in one swift stroke. Open the scene named denconverter.max that you downloaded for this tutorial. A download link is available in the description section of this movie. As you have guessed from the name, the scene represents a den, albeit devoid of any furniture for the time being. The scene is set up with Mental Ray as the renderer of choice, as befits an architectural scene. This is already a step up from the scanline render in terms of quality and physically accurate parameters. If you want, try a test render of the camera 01 view to get a feel for the space. Note that on the system that was used for this test, it took 4 minutes 16 seconds to render this shot in draft mode. Open the material editor and take a look at the scene materials. There are a few multi-sub materials displayed which are in fact made from a mix of Arcan Design and standard materials. Arcan Design is a good material to use, but the standard material is old school and is not a good fit anymore for architectural work. You will be in fact converting all of these materials into the new physical material. The new physical material, as its name implies, is physically based and is compatible with a number of rendering engines you might throw at it. It is also optimized to be used with the new Autodesk Raytracer, or ART, which is a high-quality renderer that's fast and easy to use. Dismiss the material editor and continue exploring the scene. Zoom back from the top view and note the presence of a daylight system. This is quite typical when using Mental Ray as a rendering engine. The daylight system features MR Sun and MR Sky as the tools of choice, which in turn would call for the use of the MR Physical Sky Environment background. To call up the environment dialog, you can use the 8 keyboard shortcut. Note also that Mental Ray by default favors the use of MR Photographic Exposure Control. Now, if you have used Mental Ray before, none of this should be really new to you. You must have gone through this workflow a million times already. Before you test the converter, note the presence of a few target cameras in the scene. By all accounts, you should really be using the new physical camera instead when building new projects. Physical cameras have better controls, including being able to adjust rendering exposure at the camera level instead of at a global level. There are also a few photometric free lights in the scene that do not need to be converted. These work equally well with the ART renderer. If you had to do it manually, meaning converting all the needed materials, daylight system, cameras, adjusting the environment, and so on, if you had to do all these tasks manually, it would take you a fairly long time doing what is essentially an uninteresting and boring job. This is where Scene Converter comes in. From the rendering menu, choose Scene Converter, a dialog appears. By default, it is using a preset script file named art.ms. This preset contains a set of rules that define how the conversion will take place. To understand this better, click the Open Conversion Script Folder button. In the Conversion Presets folder, you'll find the art.ms file in question, representing the conversion set of rules. In the Conversion Scripts folder, you'll find the building blocks that define those rules. You can see quite a few that you can use as they are, or you can create your own if you dabble in Max Script. Close Windows Explorer for now to continue exploring the Scene Converter dialog. You'll notice that the default option is to convert a scene to art-compatible features. In the Conversion Rules section, you can see what that means by expanding the list of features. As far as materials are concerned, This means that the Arkin design and standard materials in the scene will be converted to the new physical material. If there are special maps such as the Revit inbound Autodesk bitmap, it will be converted to a compatible map accordingly. Standard cameras will be converted to physical cameras. Standard lights will be converted to photometric lights. Even the daylight system will be converted into a more compatible sun positioner option. And exposure control will be converted to the friendlier physical camera exposure control option. To test all that, click the Convert Scene button. In a few short seconds, the conversion is done. Check that the new art renderer is now set as the default renderer, and that the environment dialog has responded in kind. The daylight system has been replaced by an easier to use sun positioner, although you may need to readjust the north direction. Note also that all cameras have been converted to physical cameras, which means you can adjust EV compensation at a camera level. As well, all materials have been converted and are now based on the new physical material. The process was certainly a lot faster than having to do all these conversions manually. Try to render the scene as you did before and note the similarities between Mental Ray and the new art renderer. Note also that it only took 43 seconds for art to render the same shot Mental Ray took 256 seconds to achieve. Both renderers were used in draft mode, so there's a bit more to achieve in terms of render quality. The tutorial scene here is only to showcase the virtues of using Scene Converter to batch convert parameters between rendering engines. To learn more about Autodesk Raytracer, watch the tutorial on this channel named Exploring the Art Renderer.